Welcome to my channel. I'm Arpita Karwa and I'm really happy today because I'm shooting the most awaited video of this year. I know that a lot of you were really waiting for this video in which I'm going to share my views about the NTA NET exam that happened in the month of December 2018. So finally, here's the video in which I'm going to talk about the major changes and I'm going to comment and give my analysis of the paper one of the NTA NET exam. But before I talk about the major changes and I highlight the main important things that you must make a note of, I would like to wish you all a very happy new year. On the eve of new year, that is on 31st December, I shared a post on all the social media pages in which I was talking to my students about how should they react to the last NET exam that happened, okay? And that post was dedicated to all those who gave the December NET exam and they were upset about the fact that it did not go as expected. And I was amazed to see that the post went viral. Like, people were so happy to read that post. They felt motivated. They felt as if they are ready to face the battle. So thank you so much for the love and wish you a very happy new year. You know, I always believe in the idea that nothing is going to change if the year changes externally, but nothing inside you changes internally. So this year, make a promise to yourself that every day you are going to do something to make yourself a better person. So before I talk about the paper, I would like to tell all of you that if you're not aware, I've already posted the official question paper and answer key on my website arpitakarwa.com. The link of both paper 1 and paper 2 is given in the description box below. So if you haven't seen the last paper, then it's time for you to go and check out. Apart from that, now it's time to look at the main changes which were there in this paper, in paper 1 particularly. So the first major change that I found in the paper was the new interface. For the first time, the paper was conducted online, okay? Earlier, the paper was conducted as a pen paper test, so OMR sheet was given to you. But for the first time, the paper was online, because of which a few students were facing problems. Like, a few students commented that, you know, they marked all the answers, but they forgot to click on the button, save and mark for review. Because of which, not even a single answer of theirs was accepted by the computer. So even after giving the entire paper and, you know, giving a superb paper, their answers were not evaluated. At the same time, there were a few students with whom I had a phone conversation and they said that, you know, the computer interface was not so user friendly. They had to shift the screen, scroll left and right in order to see the entire question, which was quite disturbing for them. But apart from these minor mistakes, I think that the online interface was really good. Number one, it definitely had saved a lot of time of these students because, you know, you don't need to go back and fill the bubbles. At the same time, the chances of committing errors in filling the bubbles were decreased significantly because now you just need to click on the computer and you need to proceed to the next question. So if I sum up, I would like to say that the online interface was good, but it could have been better, and I'm hoping that NTA would definitely improve their system in the coming. The next interesting fact I would like to share is that when I was going through the 22nd December paper 1, I found that the paper was extremely simple. If I talk about data interpretation, which actually gives a lot of stress to the students, the table was super easy to understand and super easy to calculate because the digits were like 15, 20, 25. So very normal digits were there rather than having any decimal digits. Apart from that, reading comprehension was fabulous. It was very easy. If you talk about the sections of communication, computers, you will find that, you know, the questions were very direct. For example, they'll ask you that what is the other name of the non-verbal communication? Okay, then there were questions like which of these are not audio formats? So we all know these basic things. So overall, I found that the paper was easy. I'm specifically talking about the paper which came on 22nd December shift 1. Okay, because my students, those who are appearing for English literature, they gave that paper. So I have actually sat down and analyzed that paper, and my interpretation is that paper one was comparatively easier. The next important thing that I noticed was that there was a shift in the paper pattern. If you look at the paper one of 2016 or 2017, you must have found that they were asking 5 questions from each of the 10 units. So in total, 50 questions were asked. This time, there was a shift in the paper pattern. There were some sections from which they asked 7-8 questions. From the other sections, they were hardly asking 1 or 2 questions. General awareness, which actually scares a lot of students, from that section this time, very less questions were asked. So if you are having intellect level of Alia Bhatt, then I'm pretty sure that you were saved. Apart from that, you could have seen the same thing in different units. For example, teaching aptitude, research aptitude, these were the sections from which more number of questions were asked. So you need to understand the thing that now leaving any of the units would not help, because you don't know from which unit more number of questions would come and from which unit less number of questions would come. So you need to cover the entire syllabus for paper one. The fourth important thing that you must have noticed in this year's paper one was that this time they asked questions from new topics. Okay, so some new topics were introduced. For example, if you look at reasoning, earlier they were asking questions like relationship, or they were asking us about solving any equation, or asking about statement and premises, Venn diagram. But this time they asked us distance time question. Then they also introduced clock questions, ratio questions. So these were few areas which were untouched by the students. So now it's on you that looking at the new pattern, you need to even expose yourself to the new areas which you were not touching earlier. Apart from that, if you can see a significant change, you'll find that this time's paper one was very similar to the other competitive exams like Bank, PO or SSC. So the paper pattern was different, and they are trying to make it very similar to the other competitive exams. So now it's on you that you need to start learning something more, and you just cannot define the syllabus. The syllabus is becoming vast, and the radius of the syllabus is stretching day by day. So now that I've highlighted the main important changes, you must have this question in your mind that how should we plan for the next exam? What should be the strategy according to the new pattern? So the first important thing that I would like to mention here is that please don't panic. I've seen this tendency in a lot of students that whenever there's a change in any conventional paper pattern, they'll stress out. They'll start feeling as if, okay, something has gone wrong. Now understand, some changes are for your good. This time's paper was easier. Okay, so if you devote about an hour every day for the next few months, paper one will be a very, very scoring paper for you. And if you look at the questions, if you calmly sit down and analyze them, you'll find that most of them are common sense based questions. So with practice, and if you are observant around the world, then definitely paper one will be your kind of thing. The second important thing that you must remember when it comes to the strategy is that become computer friendly. Guys, it's high time that you should go paperless. Even today I've seen students who prefer pen paper more than computers. We've got so many good apps on which you can make your notes, so many good websites on which you can practice mock tests. So it's high time that you should start using computers more, because once you get computer friendly, you will automatically feel that this computer based test is far more effective than the OMR pen paper test. Another important thing that you must make note of is that say no to guidebooks. Now, I might not make any sense to you at this time when I say this, because you might question that if not from guidebooks, then from where should we study? Understand, guys, if you look at the paper, you'll find that nothing was from the guidebooks that are available in the market. There are a lot of guidebooks which are there in the market, but the information given in the guidebooks, that is irrelevant for this paper. Now, if you see that the paper pattern is very similar to Bank PO SSC, you can make use of YouTube videos, okay? And then from YouTube itself, you can prepare for paper one. When I was preparing for paper one, I actually did not buy any guidebook. I was solely relying on internet and on YouTube for most of my information. So it's very important that you break that conventional study pattern and start using internet as a source of information. You'll find that there are a lot of YouTube channels which are giving you free information for paper one. And so many videos are there that you can easily understand any concept. You don't need to buy any paid material for paper one. That is what I'm saying from my experience. And you can also see that the same thing applies in the case of other papers as well. Now, another important thing that you must make note of is that previous year papers will help you a lot to score high in UGC NET Paper 1. The reason being is that when you start solving previous year papers, you'll find that there are very similar questions which are repeated every year. Okay, and if you have mastery over those questions, then in less time, you can score really high. It's not about hard work, it's about smart work. So you must go through the previous year papers, start solving them. Wherever you find that you're making a mistake, you can go to YouTube, to other websites, and then you can study that concept from there. And that is how you will make your own notes. And these notes will give you higher marks than any other guidebooks can give you. So these are few important tips that you must remember if you are aiming for the next NTA NET exam. So with that note, I end my discussion on the recent NTA UGC NET Paper 1. I hope that this video helped to clear a lot of your doubts. Also, I'm hoping that this video gave you clarity and gave you a broader understanding on how to prepare for Paper 1. I'll be putting a lot more videos on Paper 1 on this channel. So if you have not yet subscribed to the channel, then it's time to do that. Also, please follow me on the other social media platforms because I keep posting important updates about UGC NET on those channels and those platforms. If you have any questions, any queries, any suggestions, you can put that in the comment section below and I'll be very happy to address that in the next video lecture. Thank you so much. Happy learning. Keep loving literature. Stay tuned to arpitakarwa.com.